and you can simply download Flex from the internet. You download it, C++, okay, and use this instruction given here and install your Flex. You can see here this you can see it is downloading Flex. Right. Why is this? We will install on another day. That is not required immediately. What happens there? You will write the Lex source code. It will compile on the Lex compiler, FLex or Flex, whatever you call it. Okay? And it will generate a C code. C.c is there. Lex.yy.c is the file name. So this is the defined file name. You can't rename it. This file name will be also given by the Lex compiler. Okay. Now, it doesn't matter what C or C++ compiler you have, you can compile this yy.c code with that compiler. If you have Visual C++ and if that compiles this C code, it's no issue, you can do it. Okay? So you just do next. Accept the agreement. Next. See here, look at this. By default, it is taking a path. Three colon program file, then GNU Win32. So what we will do, this program file will remove and we will install it into the GNU Win32. Understand? This is something you must follow. Then you do next. Let all the things be there. Then GNU Win32, then place no issue. Next, download source, you can keep, no issue. Next, install. It is installed, I'm finishing it. Okay, now I need an editor to write the code. Okay, and before I go to write the code, here we need to see again the path. We will not install it in the program file. We will install it directly in C drive, C colon, dev C, PP. Right? Let it be the path. So just be careful when installing. Okay. Then you go forward. Okay, now I'm just going to finish it. Okay, so it is done for me. Please. I wish I will find it here. Advanced system settings, then you can see here. environment variable. What environment variable? You can see some paths are already there. You can add your new path into it. Okay, at the end. Just, or you can just add another entry here. Okay. So if I do another entry here, okay. I'm writing the variable name is path, and what the path I have put it here. You can see I'm giving the path here. Okay, and okay. So these paths are set. Sometimes it happens that you need to you can do here to check that whether our flex is working or not. You can simply open our CMD and do right here. So you can see it is not saying that Flex is not recognized comment. So it is entered into Flex mode, right? So if your screen is like this, then you can understand that your Flex is installed successfully. Okay, how to get out of this Flex mode in the CMD? I think it is Control C. Yeah.
Code into .l file, which will be compiled by the Lex compiler of Lex, what we have just installed. Okay. It will give you output in another file. Okay. It will not display anything. It will just generate another file called lex.yy.c. Then we will have our C compiler, because this is a C code. You can see here .c is at the end. So this is C code. We will just compile the C code and run using some C compiler. Okay. Then we can see, whether it is working or not. Okay. Now how to write the Lex program? You will find the Lex program is having three parts. Okay. So this is the structure of a Lex code. Okay. You will have three parts. First part is called declaration, second part is called regular expression rules, and third part is called subroutine definition. The subroutine definition means if you want to call something function and all, and this code is executed, okay, that part of C code, basically you will find this part is quite, most of the instructions of C language code you want to write, you can put here. Declarations, here you can put any declaration, that means what are digits supported, what are the symbols supported, what alphabets are supported, you can declare at this part. And here is the regular expression. Using regular expression, you can define strings, right? You can say how a phone number will look like, how an email address can be look like, how a keyword can be look like, how identifier of variable name that will look like. All these rules can be defined using regular expression. You can see here define a 100. Then C also will write, right? So next we'll copy the things we have written between this percent bracket and this percent closing bracket. Whatever you have written in between, it will be copied by the Lex. Okay. Then you have also defined that white space treated like this. If there is a tab, or if there is a white space. Okay. Or if there is a repetition of white space, this class means that there is repetition of tab, or repetition of all the combination of white space and tab. Okay. Letters we have defined A to Z and small A to Z. In our Lex program, if there is any small symbol, then they will not be printed as letter. Okay. Even the numbers, the digits, are not going to be printed as letter. Okay. Digit is defined 0 to 9, all digits. And operation plus the plus operation is defined by plus. So this all this it is nothing but our declaration part. Okay, this is our declaration. Then we write regular expression. So we know what is regular expression. It is a pattern. You know, it is a rule which maps some pattern. Okay. So you see here some regular expression are given. So you want to ignore all the white space. Then you can just give this. Then we are saying that if O plus, you know what is O plus. If plus sign is there, then it will be treated as O plus. Okay. So if you get O plus, we are just returning O plus as a token. Okay. Then if you get any repeated combination of alphabet, you are treating that as printf is alphabet. Okay. We are just printing the alphabet. Okay. And if you are getting dot or new line, then you are just going normal default way. You can you may not write this right now. Okay. Then subroutine definition. In subroutine definition, you are simply doing the C code. Main function you have to give, otherwise you know the C code it will generate will not have main function. Main function you have to give. And you have to from main you have to call YY next function. What is this YY next function? This function is it, you know, will be generated, and in this function corresponding C code for this part will be stored. Okay, and that function will be called by main. Now in let's.yy.c file there will be main function, there will be no, the main function is called this function, yylex function. And then the body part of yylex, the corresponding code will be here. Okay. So with that, the code generated by Rex will be able to run on C compiler. Okay. So there is many other functions in Rex. We can use them, and later we will see how to use all these functions. Okay. So you can see here the whole code put it together, and it will look like this. I've opened a blank file. You can see here, and I just want to. Okay. Now, what I will do, I will just copy my code to there. And save it. So I have my lex.l file. So what I have to do right now, I have to compile this, right? So lex file will not be compiled by C++, correct? I have to open this command prompt, and then I have to go to the path where it is. So let me see the path. Okay. Then write X. What was the file name? mylex.l. Enter. So my file is compiled. Okay. You can see there is no error. Simply new line came in the command prompt. That means source code you type yourself. That is better. I can copy and paste. You know? But if you try it, it is another iteration in your mind that what you are writing. Copying and pasting is not a good thing for source code, for you guys. Remember to understand? It is really understood. Type it and then you just acknowledge me.
they can type it from there.
So I just want to go to my file where it is. You can see I have one file generated here, legs.yy.c. Understand? In code folder, if you see this. In the code folder, I had this mylegs.l file, and using this command, flex space mylegs.l, I have compiled my file, and after compilation, this legs.yy.c is generated. Understand? So here is a snapshot, you can see of this file, what is there inside, you can see. The content of the C file, what is generated, you can see in this corner of the screen. Okay, now what I will do, I will open this C file into Delphi Plus Plus, okay? So, will open this.yy.c. Now I give 9 as input. You can see it is giving output this is 7, this is. I give a letter y, it is giving output y. It is not saying it is something else, right? Okay. So this is how it is working. If you just want to see, modify this for digit as well as alphabet, you can just
go a number, right? Or it's
well, that is, you have to, I'll show you how it happens. Here we have plus, na?
Yes, sir.
Plus means what? The defined part, the digit is defined here. So let me show you that. Okay, and this can be put here. I expect it. Understand? Now you save it. You compile it. Without error. Now I open it. Okay, compilation of the done. Run it. Okay. So now you understand this thing.
Just compile it. So if we type,
yeah,
it's any number.
Good.
So.